You ever think about what keeps the skies safe? No, not Superman. I'm talking about air defense systems, the real deal when it comes to shooting down threats from above. Two big dogs in this fight are the S-400 and the Patriot. One's Russian-made, the other's from the US of A. Both do the same basic job, but like any good tool, each has its own strengths and weaknesses. Now, I'm not one for fancy jargon, so let's break this down in plain English. We're talking about keeping things out of the sky that ain't supposed to be there. Think fighter jets, bombers, even those newfangled drones everyone's talking about. These missile systems are like the bouncers of the sky, and they don't mess around. Imagine trying to pick the best tool for a job, right? You wouldn't use a screwdriver to hammer a nail. It's the same with air defense. Countries gotta figure out what kind of threats they're facing and what system fits their needs best. That's what we're gonna dig into. The nitty-gritty of these missile systems so you can see what's what. Let's talk distance, folks. When it comes to air defense, reach is king. The S-400, it's got some serious range, boasting up to 250 miles. That's like throwing a football from New York City and hitting something in Boston. The Patriot, it ain't no slouch either, clocking in around 100 miles. Still impressive, but not quite in the same league. Now picture this, a bad guy plane is coming in high. The S-400 can hit targets up to 20 miles high. That's like stacking six Mount Everest on top of each other. The Patriot, it tops out around 19 miles. Again, not bad, but when it comes to high altitude threats, the S-400 has the edge. Think of it like this. The S-400 is like having a really long range rifle, while the Patriot is more like a powerful shotgun. Both can get the job done, but they excel in different situations. Now, let's talk about the missiles themselves. The S-400 is like a buffet of destruction with different missiles for different targets. It's got ones for short range, long range, high altitude, you name it. The Patriot, it's a bit more specialized, mainly focused on taking down aircraft and ballistic missiles. Imagine you're a chef, right? You wouldn't use the same knife to chop veggies and fillet a fish. Same idea here. The S-400's got a whole set of knives for any air defense situation. The Patriot, it's got a couple of really good knives, perfect for specific jobs. This variety gives the S-400 flexibility. It can adapt to different threats, kind of like a Swiss Army knife of air defense. The Patriot, while more specialized, is still a powerful tool when used for its intended purpose. Section 4. The price of protection, costs, and upkeep. Now let's talk about the elephant in the room, cost. These systems ain't cheap. The S-400, it's like buying a fleet of luxury cars. The Patriot, it's more like buying a really, really nice house. And that's just the initial cost. You gotta factor in maintenance, training, upgrades. It adds up fast. Think of it like owning a boat. Everybody wants one until they realize how much it costs to keep it afloat. Same with these missile systems. Countries gotta weigh the benefits of having top-notch air defense against the cost of actually operating the darn things. For some countries, the S-400's lower price tag might be tempting, but you get what you pay for. The Patriot, while pricier, comes with more support from the US and its allies, which can be invaluable in a pinch. Section 5. Playing nice with others. System compatibility. Here's another thing to consider, compatibility. Can these systems play nice with other defenses? The S-400, it's mostly designed to work within Russia's military network. The Patriot, on the other hand, is built for interoperability with NATO systems. Imagine you're trying to plug a European appliance into an American outlet. You need an adapter, right? It's kind of like that with these systems. The Patriot is like having the right adapter for working with other NATO systems. The S-400, not so much. This is a big deal for countries allied with the US. They need a system that can seamlessly integrate with what they already have. The Patriot's compatibility makes it a natural choice for them. Section 6, and the winner is deciding the best fit. So which system reigns supreme? Well, there ain't no easy answer. It's like asking if a hammer's better than a screwdriver. Depends on the job, right? The S-400 boasts impressive range and firepower, while the Patriot offers compatibility and a proven track record. Ultimately, the best system depends on a country's specific needs. Gotta consider the threats they face, their budget, their technical expertise, and even political factors. It's a complex decision with no one-size-fits-all answer. Think of it like this. Buying an air defense system is like buying a truck. You gotta figure out what you need it for. Hauling heavy loads, off-roading, cruising around town. Once you know what you need, then you can find the right tool for the job. Same goes for keeping the skies safe.